How are you guys doing? Today is Monday, October 4th, 2021. I'm James Sims, and for this episode of The Elite, I'm going to preview the wild card round for the 2021 MLB Playoffs. And without further ado, I'm actually very excited to get into this because the last season, it was so impacted by COVID that they actually had to change the way the playoff was completely structured. They allowed 16 teams to enter the playoffs. That's 8 teams from the American League and 8 teams from the National League. And of course, because the season had to get shortened from 162 games to 60 games, they had to make up for that difference. But now this is the first full season since 2019. This is the first full season that I've been able to cover. And without further ado, I have no problem. It's my pleasure to kind of explain how this structure works. And of course, the teams that make up the structure and how we are going to navigate through each round of the playoffs. Because as of right now, there are 10 teams that are currently competing for the 2021 World Series. 20 teams have already been eliminated. The teams that are remaining are the teams that have won each division. In the National League, the San Francisco Giants won the National League West with the best record, so they have the number one seed there. The Milwaukee Brewers won the National League Central, but their record wasn't better than the Giants, so they have the number two seed. And the Atlanta Braves won the National League East, but they didn't have better records than the Brewers or the Giants, so the Braves are coming in with the 3 seed. In the American League, the team that finished with the best record was the Tampa Bay Rays, so they have the number one seed. The Houston Astros won the American League West, so they come in with the number two seed because they didn't have a better record than the Rays. And then the White Sox, who had the third best record out of the American League division leaders as they won the American League Central, they are going to come in with the third seed, so that's already 6 of the 10 teams. The two wild card teams are the teams that are the best two remaining teams in each league, regardless of division. As you can see, the Boston Red Sox and the New York Yankees actually play in the same division, so it doesn't matter if it's the second best record from a division, it's the two best teams remaining. And for the American League, those teams are the New York Yankees and the Boston Red Sox. And they finished with the same record, outside of the playoff picture. The tiebreaker ended up going to the Red Sox, I believe, because of the head-to-head matchup. I don't know that 100% for a fact, but I believe that is the reason. And because of that, the Boston Red Sox are going to play the New York Yankees in a single elimination wild card game on the 5th, which is tomorrow at 8 o'clock on ESPN. Garrett Cole, the elite starting pitcher for the Yankees, is going to take the mound for them. And Nathan Eovaldi is going to take the mound for the Boston Red Sox. The winner of this matchup will face off against the first seed Tampa Bay Rays, already from their division, in a best of 5 series in the American League Division Series. And in the National League, the two teams that are making up these two teams are the Los Angeles Dodgers and the St. Louis Cardinals. They're a little bit different from the American League, mainly because the Los Angeles Dodgers finished with the second best record in all of baseball this year. The only reason that they're playing for a wild card is that the team with the best record in baseball played in their division. Since they didn't win their division, they're placed with the rest of the field. And since even though they finished 14 games ahead of the St. Louis Cardinals, the Cardinals were able to squeak into the playoffs, earn that spot, and now the Cardinals will have to play against the Los Angeles Dodgers in Los Angeles on the 6th in a single elimination game to determine who's going to play against the San Francisco Giants in San Francisco for a best of 5 series, even though the Giants finished only one game ahead of the 4th seed in the playoffs. That's how it works. And once those single elimination games are done, I will get back to you for the National League Division Series. And with that said, first, I want to thank the MLB website for giving me what I needed. And I want to thank everyone for listening 12, 4.5 minutes of this piece. I want to thank everyone for listening. I want to thank you all. I hope all is well, and I will catch you with another episode of with a preview of the divisional series round once both wild card knockout games have been finished. With that said, thanks once again. I hope all is well, and I'll catch you with another episode of The Elite after this because there's a lot in the end of the MLB season I got to get through. Thanks once again for listening. I hope all is well, and peace out.